In this video, I would like to show you how to use Solver, which allows you to change multiple variables to find an optimal solution. You can use Solver for optimization problems to better allocate scarce resources, analyze and control risk, data visualization, forecasting, text mining, and predictive analytics for larger datasets. Solver is an Excel add-in that's not automatically activated when you install the product. I will show you how to add the Solver. You can just open Excel. To see if you already have Solver installed, click the Data tab of the ribbon. If it's installed, it will appear at the right edge of this ribbon tab. If not, I'll click the File tab, click Options, and then click the Add-ins category. Then at the very bottom of the Excel Options dialog box, I'll make sure that Excel Add-ins is selected. If not, you can select it from this drop-down list and then click Go. In the list of available add-ins, you will see the Solver add-in, so check its box and click OK. When you do, Excel adds Solver to the new analysis group on the Data tab of the ribbon. You can use Solver to find solutions to complex problems with a lot of inputs. The scenario I'm assuming is that a company has a lot of different products to sell and can only afford to buy a few and maintain limited stock of these products. It could be because the business owner has limited cash or space to store these many items. As you can see, worksheet shows information related to different products, like the cost price, the profit percentage, and the stock of products. This is what we wish to find out, the optimal level of stock the owner should keep under these situations to generate maximum profit. Then in the bottom section, in cell F12 through F16, you have information about the limitations I want to put on this model. I have total revenue, which is what I'm trying to maximize by keeping efficient stock of products. I have the minimum stock I want to maintain for every product. As products 7 and 8 are expensive, I don't want to maintain more than 1000 products of those. Then the maximum number I want to maintain for product 1 to 6 is 5000, and also the limit of total products I can keep in my warehouse is 25000. My goal is to find out the mix of different products that creates the most revenue, which is calculated here in cell F12. After you create your Solver worksheet, you need to create the model that contains the rules the Solver will use to find the solution. I'll click the Data tab and then I'll click the Solver button. It displays the Solver parameters dialog box. The first thing I need to do is set my objective, and in this case, that is the cell that I want to maximize, that is the total revenue in cell F12. Now I need to tell Solver whether I want to maximize that value, minimize it, or go toward a target. In this case, I want to maximize the value, so I'll leave the max option button selected. And now I need to identify the cells that Solver can change to find the maximum value for cell F12. To do that, I will click in the by changing variable cells box. Click the collapse dialog box button and select cells E2 through E9. Those contain the number of items in stock for each product. Now click the expand dialog box button, and you can see that E2 through E9 appears in the by changing variable cells box. Now you need to add constraints, and those are the rules that Solver will use to find the solution. To begin adding constraints, I will click the add button. When I set up my worksheet, I summarize those rules in the worksheet itself, and you can see them here in cell E13 through F16. All we need to do is to add those to Solver. So let's go ahead and add them one by one. My first constraint is minimum stock I want to maintain for every product, and that constraint refers to all the products. So that would be cell E2 through E9. So I'll just select those cells. I want those values to be greater than or equal to 100. So I'll click the operator button and select greater than or equal. And the constraint is in cell F13. So I'll click that while the cursor is flashing in the constraint box. So this rule tells Solver that E2 through E9 must have at least the value in cell F13. And at present, that is 100. I want to create additional rules, so I'll click add. For my next rule, I want to have the maximum stock for 7 and 8. So that means I want to set cells E8 and E9 to be less than or equal to the value in cell F14. As the products 7 and 8 are expensive, I don't want to maintain more than 1000 each. I'll click add so I can continue adding rules. Now I want to have the maximum stock for product 1 to 6, and that will be 5000 each. So that will be cell references E2 through E7. Less than or equal to, which is already there, click in the constraint box, and that is for the cell F15. So once again, products 1 through 6, I want them to have less than 5000 apiece. I'll click add so I can create my final constraint, and that is the total number of products. The total number is in cell E10, so I'll click cell reference and I'll click cell E10. I want the total to be less than or equal to constraint, that is in cell F16, currently 25000. In the end, I want to make sure that the output given by the solver in cell E2 to E9 are integer numbers. As you know, the number of stock products cannot be in fraction. So everything looks good, and I'll click OK. Doing so displays the solver parameter dialog box with all the rules inside. Now to get my solution, all I need to do is click the solve button. Solver indicates that it has found a solution. So here I have my solution, a revenue of around $27,000 with the stock of products as shown in cell E2 to E16. And it looks like a pretty good solution. So let me know in the comment section if you want me to show the use of Solver for different types of scenarios. Also, if you found this video useful, please like the video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks.